Well, friend, it's time to clean up your act. If you still use cotton swabs to clean your ears, best look a bit lower at your belly button. I bet you've last cleaned it a long time ago, if ever. Still, there's a lot of stuff going on there. Scientists have found a veritable rainforest of bacteria in the human navel, and some of them are bound to be harmful. So, cleaning the belly button is a must. But simply poking your soapy fingertip in there under the shower ain't gonna cut it. For proper navel care, if you have an innie, take a cotton swab, dip it in rubbing alcohol, and rub the insides of your belly button. Stare in horror at how dirty your cotton swab has become. Then take another one and repeat the procedure until the swab comes out clean. After that, take yet another cotton swab, wet it under the tap, and gently rub your navel again to get rid of rubbing alcohol. It might dry your skin otherwise. Finally, take a long expected shower and don't forget to dry your belly button with the corner of your towel. Now, if you have an outie navel, things are a lot easier. Get some soap onto a cloth, lather it up, and rub the soapy cloth onto your belly button. Rinse it under the shower and let the towel do the drying job. Now, speaking of towels, don't forget to change yours at least every 3 days. It collects a lot of moisture, and since it's pretty warm in your bathroom, the towel is a perfect breeding ground for bacteria. When it starts to smell unpleasant, throw it in the washing machine ASAP. It means there are already millions of colonies of bacteria and yeast. Since you've already used up all your cotton swabs on your belly button, you won't be tempted to clean your ears with them, and good for you. The inner part of your ear is pretty sensitive, and you can easily damage it with a cotton tip. So don't go poking in there with your nails either. Chances are you'll push the wax even further too, so it's a lose-lose. To properly clean wax from your ears, take an eyedropper and fill it with baby oil, mineral oil, or hydrogen peroxide. Apply a few drops to either of your ears and go about your business. The wax will have to soften for a few days now. Then take a rubber bulb, fill it with warm water, and very carefully rinse your ear canals with it. Tilt your head to the side and pull your earlobe down for better access. Don't push the bulb too hard, or you'll end up with water stuck in your ear. When done rinsing, tip your head to the other side and let the water out. Repeat with the other ear. After that, dry the outer part of your ears with a towel or a cotton pad. This time, you can also use a wet cotton swab, if you have any left, to clean the outer part too. Just don't go too deep inside. If you still feel uncomfortable after such a cleaning, you may want to repeat it again after a day or two. And if the problem remains even then, it's best to go to a doctor. You might have a wax plug. The areas behind your ears also crave your attention and almost never get it. Don't make them sad, otherwise they'll accumulate sebum, the oily stuff that covers your hair when you don't wash it, and might eventually start smelling like cheese. This is a warning sign there's a lot of bacteria behind your ears. Before you shower, take a cotton pad and dip it in white vinegar. Rub it behind your ears to get rid of sebum and nasty germs. Then just go to the shower and wash as usual. Simple as that. Even if you brush your teeth twice a day and use a mouthwash every time, you might still notice you've got bad breath. This could be caused by bacteria on your tongue, so consider cleaning it too. This is especially true if your tongue is coated with some whitish film. It's best if you buy a special tool for tongue scraping, but even a clean spoon or your toothbrush will do. Pull out your tongue, looking at yourself in the mirror. Put the scraper as far back into your mouth as you can without gagging on it, and press it to your tongue. Now pull the scraper across the whole surface of the tongue, back to tip. Don't try to do it the other way around. You don't want to swallow all that filth, do you? Now rinse off the stuff you've gathered on the scraper, and repeat once or twice more until all the coating is gone from your tongue. As a bonus to fresher breath and better looking tongue, you might also notice that you feel taste better. Your taste buds, free from the coating on them, will discern sweet, sour, bitter, and other tastes more acutely after cleaning. Dirty nails aren't only unsightly, but can also bring you harm. When you scratch an itch, for example, you make tiny cracks in your skin that you don't even see. And if your nails aren't clean, the dirt and germs from under them may get into your bloodstream. For proper nail care, washing your hands with soap is usually enough. But if the grime persists, soak a cotton pad or swab in warm, soapy water and carefully clean underneath all your fingernails until there's no more visible dirt. If you have piercing in any part of your body, remember it requires proper care and cleaning too. First, make sure you know what kind of metal your body accessories are made of and consult your piercer or doctor on what precautions to take. For most accessories, though, saline rinsing will be enough. It's best to buy a package of sterile saline, and if it's unavailable, go for a saltwater solution. Take a quarter of iodine-free sea salt and dissolve it in a cup of warm, distilled water. Wash your hands not to infect your pierced area. Remember the dirty fingernails? Yeah. Take your saltwater solution and apply it to the piercing. It might take a different approach to different places. If it's your ears, then the best choice is to take a clean piece of gauze, soak it in the solution, and dab it gently on the piercing. If it's the belly button, you can take the cup with the solution and turn it carefully over your piercing while sitting or lying back and sloshing the liquid inside a bit. After you've done, dry the piercing with a paper towel. If the piercing is still healing, don't use your regular towel. There might be some harmful germs on it, especially if you've not changed it recently. Washing your feet with soap or shower gel isn't enough. The skin on your feet is much thicker and harder than anywhere else on your body, and it gets even tougher with age. If you don't take good care of your feet, the skin there might eventually crack, causing discomfort and bringing risk of infection. Oh no! To avoid this, give them a hot spa from time to time. Prepare a warm bath in advance and take a few pinches of salt, the sea variety. Rub the salt onto your feet with your hands, taking special care of the heels and toe pads. These areas take the brunt of activity when you walk. Then soak your feet in the bath you prepared for 10 minutes. Read a book or check the news feed on your smartphone while waiting. Then, use a foot scrubber on the whole surface of your feet to get rid of exfoliated skin cells. Dry them with a towel and go. Do this at least once a week to give your feet a much-needed relief. You might notice that your elbows have gotten darker than the rest of your arms. It happens because the skin there is rather thin and elastic since you use those joints a lot. To even out your skin shade, take time to cleanse and moisturize your elbows separately from the rest of your skin. While taking a shower, lather up and wash your elbows specifically, then add some moisturizer on top. After that, exfoliate them with a special body wash or a sugar scrub. Then dry yourself with a towel, and after a few weeks of such care, you'll probably notice your elbows getting lighter.